Good afternoon, everyone. This is Christy with Van Aan & Company. It's Thursday, July 11th. I'm going to go over the markets with you. We had a USDA crop report today that they threw out quite a bit of bearish information for corn. They kind of digested it, broke down about 10 cents, and then rallied out of there and really just said, we're not going to believe these numbers. We believe you'll see resurvey of lower acre numbers, yield reductions to come, and we're not going to believe it. They gave us over a 2 billion bushel carryout forecast for next year after being all the way down to 1.6. And so it was really, really bearish, like I said. So down 10 cents on the day, rallying back here to close 8 cents higher. So you actually closed about 18 cents off the low for December corn. That was really impressive to see. It also helped that corn had a friend in the wheat complex. We saw friendly numbers, nothing huge, but you saw such aggressive selling over the weeks prior coming into this report on wheat that really you just saw people start to step back in. So anywhere from 12 in Minneapolis to 20 higher in Kansas City wheat. A little bit disappointing was soybeans, only up 4.5 cents on the day, still positive nonetheless, but really they had friendly numbers, but they just did not want to follow along with corn and wheat. Maybe waiting out to see some China news, see if we can get trade talks together, but for now, still positive on the day, just not as high as we were expecting to see with some friendly numbers. Meat markets, live cattle, feeder cattle able to fight its way to slightly positive, 25 cents higher in live cattle, feeder cattle, just over that higher. But hog markets down over $2 on the day as they've really traded both sides in cash. Hogs have been really a thorn into the futures side. Outside markets were quiet today, so moving forward, really what we're watching is just seeing how much the traders can fight off that USDA number and continue to rally when we're posting a 2-3 billion bushel carryout on last year and a 2 billion bushel carry forecast for next year. Seeing if you can carry through with that and then just watching weather models as we move forward, as there's a lot of heat in there, so we're going to be making sure that we get some rain or you're going to see these markets start to really rally out of here. Do have to close with a disclaimer. Trading futures and options involves risk loss and is not suitable for all producers. This is a solicitation. Have a great day.